Hello students, so today we are doing the active and passive voice topic, a topic which is very, very important for our AILET preparation, and we have questions put up on this. So I'm telling you the tidbits, the decoding the main topic, that is active and passive voice, what are the rules of it, how we have to do it, and what are the things we need. Now, to start with, there are 12 tenses in English, out of which only 8 tenses make the change of active and passive voice. Only 8 tenses, right? So, which tenses do not make this change? The tenses which do not make the change are, out of these, that is future continuous, present perfect continuous, past perfect continuous, and future perfect continuous. These do not make change. They do not change. These four tenses do not change. Then what changes? What is the thing and how do these changes come up into picture? Now, to bring that into mind, we have first tense that we start with, simple present tense. Now, simple present tense, first we understand the formula that we have to apply in this. We use object plus helping verb plus V3 plus by plus subject. Right, dear? Okay, this is the formula that we follow. Object plus helping verb plus V3 plus by plus subject. In this scenario, when we change a sentence of simple present tense, the helping verbs are is, am, and are. Right? Now, in this situation, if the sentence says, lawyers win the case. So, we change from the active to passive, that is subject, verb, and object, by the formula that is here. The case, singular verb because of the word case, is won by the lawyers. Right, dear? This is the first part of a simple present tense that I have made the change. Let's turn to the other tenses. We have total 8 changes according to the tense. Moving on to second verb. Now, when we have the second tense, that is present perfect tense. Now, present perfect tense, we use the word that is helping verb, been is used. The sentence says, I'm taking the same sentence so that you can mark out the difference in the scenario and the situation. Lawyers have won the case. So, using the word been in the sentence, the case, that is subject, verb and object. Since it is case, so we change it to has. The case has been won by the lawyers. The case has been won by the lawyers. Right? Moving on to present continuous tense. Now, when we have a present continuous tense, as we have been in this sentence, so we use the word that is being. In this, the helping verb given to us is being, right? The remaining is MR as per the object, right? So, if we have a sentence, that is, the sentence says, lawyers are winning the case. This is the sentence, and we change it as per subject, verb and object. What would be the answer? The case has, why has, no, that's what I was wondering, you're not marking out. The case singular is being won by the lawyers. Right, students? Now moving on to our fourth tense, simple past. Since present perfect continuous would not be changed, as this is something which do not accept the rules of the passive voice. So in this case here, we have simple past tense. Now what does simple past tense say? Simple past tense, we use the helping verb was and were. Everything that is fixed here, this is the helping verb we have to use. The sentence says, lawyers won the case. So the change will be, the case was won by lawyers. I hope you're getting it. What are the changes we are making? You have to be just aware that which helping verb is used and how we can follow that helping verb. Right, moving on to the next in this scenario, past continuous. Now, as per this continuous, the same follows. This being is used in past continuous too. The same being that we used here is used here too. The sentence is, lawyers were winning. I have taken the same sentence again and again so that you can mark out the difference and how changes have to be made. Lawyers were winning the case, right? We would change it. The case was being won by the lawyers. If it is article the given, you would mark it. If it is not given, you would not write it again. Sometimes I've used and sometimes I've skipped. So accordingly, you would also follow the same. Future continuous, we do not make the change. Moving on to the next tense, that is the sixth pattern, that is simple future. The model doesn't change. Will shall remains will shall. In reported speech, we change will to would or shall to should. But in active passive, this change is not done. So please keep in mind this and do not forget what you're supposed to do in this context. So future, simple future will change to, we would use the word be along with this as the helping verb. And let's make the change. Lawyers will win the case. So the change will be, the case will be won by lawyers. Right? And moving on to future perfect. And the last one, that is past perfect. In both the cases, we would use been as we did in present perfect. Let's make these changes here. Look at the sentence. Thank you. You have understood this now? That's awesome. With all the perfect, so it's just to summarize the thing. First, we change up the past perfect sense. That is, it's so simple to do it. I had shown you with one sentence itself. Just have a look. I just give you a minute that you have seen all the 8 tenses changes, and all these 8 tenses changes are clear to you. If not, please do put up your question. Come on, students, any problem? Let's move on to the next thing. Right? Now we take a sentence when there are questions. If there are questions, there are questions of various type. There are questions of WH questions, that is the questions we have who, whose, whom, which, that and as. If we have questions besides this, then we have do, does, did questions, is, am, are, was, were questions. So how do we deal with questions in active and passive voice? Let's turn to that. Questions, right? If we have questions with do, does, they will change to is, am, are, right? If there are questions with did, they will change to was, were, right? If there are questions as per the tense, if it is continuous question, if it is with question with WH word, all the words would remain the same except who will change to by whom. Otherwise, all question words would remain the same. With the questions with perfect, we would have been. With questions with continuous tense, we would have being. Questions with modals, we would have be. This is the simple manner we would deal with questions. So if it is perfect, as I've had, if it is am, are, was, were, if it is modal questions, if it is WH questions, or if it is do, does, did questions. Let's consider the questions here in one go and understand how we would change them. Now listen and see the questions carefully, right? Turning to the questions here. If we have the question, we have done the 8 types of tenses. Now we are seeing the questions and how can those questions be changed and analyzed. So here we have the 9th one, that is do or does question. Do you study English? The question has to be changed with a question only. And so in this case, a simple little trick. You'd remove the word do. Right? Now, how would you change it? You study English. This is subject, this is verb, this is object. Right? You'd make the sentence English, since is, am, are is to be used. So, with English, it will be is. If you make this step, instead of skipping this step, you would never make a difference. English is studied by you. And you put this is here. Is English studied by you? So simple, isn't it? Right. Take up a sentence with does. Does he perform I make a change in the sentence. Does he attempt the questions? And a question mark. So the answer would change. We remove the word does as usual. Subject, verb and object. And we change it. The questions are attempted by him. And we put a question mark and cut the word are, and taking up the word are here, are the questions attempted by him. You can see the step I'm taking. This makes the step very easy, very interesting, and you would not make a mistake. I've made the questions with do, does. Let's start with question with did. It's just a reading you have to do. Did they complete the test? Right? So in this scenario, I think there's a problem in this I put up here. So we'd mark it did. Very good. Now what we would do? They is the subject and complete is the verb and test is the object. Subject, verb, object. The test was completed by them. Question mark. Don't forget the question mark ever. And put this was in front and make the sentence like this. Was the test completed by them? Can you see how did I do this? You've seen do, does, did questions. You've understood them. Let's turn to WH questions. Questions with perfect form. Questions with continuous forms. And continuous ke alawa questions with modals. Right, students? Let's move to those. I hope you've jotted it down very carefully and you've not missed anything. WH questions. Now in WH questions, we have who broke the glass. Now, which is the tense? Past tense. Which helping verbs we use with past tense? Was, were. Who will change to? By whom. Then the helping verb, by whom was the glass broken? Question mark. Don't forget your question mark here, because although you will be having an objective choice, so if a choice doesn't have an objective, choice doesn't have the question mark, you will not mark it as the answer here in this situation. Right, moving on to next here. What language were they speaking? Right? Now, what language is a question word? There's no change. I told you in WH questions, except one, that is the change we have in the who and whom. We do not make a change in other question words. So it is what language? It would remain this what language. So we'd make the change. What language? Right? Then, were they speaking? So we have subject and verb. So, what language was? Why was? Because language is singular. Being because of continuous tense. By them. The trick is very simple. The understanding is damn easy. And things are very, very interesting. That what language was being spoken by them? Next. When do you complete the task? So see, all WH words, all WH words remain the same. Which WH word changes, students? Only one WH word changes. Which one? That is only the word who changes to whom. So otherwise, not so. So in this case here, when do you complete the task? When do is removed, is the task completed by you? When is the task completed by you? Have you understood this? Is this clear? So we had who, what, when, and why. Any other question, what comes in your mind, you're most welcome to take it. Why did you speak truth? So we have changed here. Why? Now, did is the helping verb with the past tense. Why was truth spoken by you? Can you see this? Why was truth spoken by you? Yes. So you have seen WH questions too. You have seen do, does, did questions. And let's move now to the helping verb questions of was, were, has, have, had, and models. What you have to insert in them? Main. That's it. And subject object would interchange their position. Have you done your homework? Now, subject, verb. This is the verb and this is the object. Now you have to decide the helping verb with the object. What is the object, singular or plural? Singular. So it will be starting with has, because the object is singular. Has the homework been done by you? Has the homework been done by? Moving on to next. Has he cooked the dish? Has he cooked the dish? So, has he cooked the dish? Again, verb, subject, and object. Since it's a singular again, so it will remain the same. Has the dish been cooked by him? And if it is had sentence, had they prepared the project? And so the answer, as per verb, subject, and object, had the project been prepared by them. Can you see this? Right? Moving on to questions with is MR or was were. Randomly we take it, there will be no problem. Is she washing the clothes? So what is clothes? It's a plural form. So it will be, are the clothes being washed by her? Fifth, were they cooking the pasta? Since pasta is singular dish, so was pasta, since you can make it they cooking pasta, so since it's a helping verb with ing, so what we would use being, as we are doing here, was the pasta being cooked by them? Am I doing the task? No need to worry about am I doing the task. In this situation, am I doing the task? What is the problem with am is that you have taken am as a helping verb. Am I doing the task? So it will be the task. So is the task being done by me? Can you see this? This is clearly visible and clearly done. Any question, doubt, controversy, you're most welcome to ask your doubts, if any. Right? Everything clear? Let's move to the next. Okay. Now we have taken all the things with 8 tenses. We have taken things with helping verbs. And we had taken things with questions. WH questions, yes and type questions, or the questions with helping verb models and so on. Now let's take the questions where we have subject missing, object missing, or imperative sentence. Open the door. So what is to be done in such scenarios? Since the paper is objective, so we need not worry about it and we follow the things accordingly. The question says, in the imperative sentence, what is imperative? Imperative sentence is order, command, or a request. For example, we have the sentence, please open the door. Now, what is missing is the subject, right? Open is the verb and door is the object. But what about the subject? So, you remove the word please and you will change it. You are requested. Right, the formula we use for this, the formula 2 plus verb first form, which is called in English infinitive. You are requested to open the door. Right, second one, if you give somebody without the word please, same sentence. This is verb and this is object. In this situation, we use it, let the door what are we using? Let plus object plus be plus verb third form. So following the formula, let the door be opened. Right, students? You've understood what you have to do, imperative sentence? Shut your mouth. Do not talk in class. Take up two more. Now, this is not a request. You can see. So now in this, we don't have an object, so we can have no passive for a sentence of this type. But if we have the sentence like this, don't open the door. Since the object was missing in this, so we can't have a passive in this. Don't open the door. So let the door, same formula, be not opened. Right? Can you see that? Kindly complete your task. So in this case, you are requested to complete your task. Can you see this? Yes, that's wonderful. Now let's turn to after imperative sentence. Some sentences where we have to seek, besides questions or besides a simple sentence, we have an adverb of manner. What do we do in such cases? Adverb of manner. Now, adverb of manner answers the question how. Right? You don't have to mug it up. The only formula you have to keep in mind is it comes before V3 in passive voice. I give you an example to explain. He completes the verb carefully. Can you see how does he complete the work? Carefully. He completes the work carefully. So we have subject, verb, object, and adverb. A simple SVOA formula. So the change would be the verb is completed by him. What about carefully? Here is the word. Only placement. This could be an error. Please note carefully. The work is carefully completed by him. It is used before verb third form. She speaks English fluently. How does she speak English? Fluently. So where do we place an adverb of manner? English is fluently spoken by her. Can you see this? Before verb third form, this is third form. Because no passive voice sentence can be made without a V3 form. It can only be done when we have a verb third form. And when we have a verb third form, we place adverb of manner after it. If there is adverb of place or time, what do? We don't follow this formula. What is the change? See the position. There is no placement of adverb of place or time before verb. So where is it placed? In the end of the sentence. Just the remaining sentence as usual is complete. And in the end of the sentence, we place it like. Now you can see I have added subject, verb, and object, an adverb of manner, an adverb of place. Right? So the answer would be, the questions are answered now gracefully, so it will be naturally. I have to make it before V3. Can you see this? I've used adverb of place just in the end of the sentence, an adverb of manner before the verb third form. For the error detection, you have to keep in mind this point very, very carefully, right? This shouldn't be mistaken at any cost. And if it is adverb of time, how would you have questions? Now look up. I would tell you how questions would be asked. So the answer would be, can you see this? A speech was wonderfully delivered by Modi in Delhi. If it is a place added, now the sequence of adverb of manner, place, time follows up manner, place and time. If three adverbs are there, then we follow this sequence, that all the three adverbs follow this formula, that all the three are placed in such a manner. Right? Now we're moving on to the next thing in this. Okay, yes, I was saying that a student was, you know, waiting up for the message, so any message has been passed on or not, right? So moving on to our next in this question, related to the errors we would have on this. We would have questions on error detection or sentence improvement on this. For example, first one, the garden was maintained well by the gardener. Pick out the word which is incorrect in the following sentence. Right? Moving on to second. I'll have to change. Yes. I'm giving 5 sentences. You could see what errors you would mark in the following sentences. See this, I take a change. Now look up at the errors that we have marked related to the active and passive voice. See the first one. The garden was maintained well by the gardener. Now as per the rule, we know very carefully that in this scenario, garden, now if it is a garden and if it is maintained, so you can see that adverb of manner, the rule says that adverb of manner is placed before V3. So garden was maintained well is wrong, and it will be here the garden was well maintained by the gardener. Why so? Because adverb of manner is placed before V3. Cut it off and put it here. This is the error. The sentence needs an improvement. Next question. The bell is rung loudly in the morning by the driver. Now there is first thing. The problem related to is loudly, and where should loudly be? Before verb third form. So it has to be placed here. Is loudly rung. And there's another problem in the same part. You have placed the time in the morning. And where is the doer? The bell is loudly rung by the driver in the morning, because the doer would come here. So by the driver has to be replaced. And to be placed here by the driver. Can you see this carefully? Yes. Moving to question number 3. Now in this sentence, how to judge the sentence is active or the sentence is passive? Now, are they the doer of actions? Yes, they do the work. So they is the subject. If they is the subject, we can't use the word been. When is been used? When the object comes first, in that case we use been. And so they have done the work would be the correct sentence. Nothing to be added further in the following sentence, because there is the doer and this is the object. Next question says questions are wonderfully attempted by LPTs. The sentence says questions, object, are helping verb, wonderfully adverb manner attempted. So sentence is right. There is no error in the sentence. Right? And moving on to question number 5. Instructions will be reading in the exams. Will the instructions read on their own? No. They'll be read by somebody. So in this case, there is no ing form required. because they will not do the work on their own. Because ice creams or instructions or anything which is an object, this needs a subject to be there to complete its sense. Otherwise, the questions cannot be taken in this perspective. This makes an error in the following sentence that if you are taking it in this way, they would not have the point of view. And so when we have active and passive voice, we have many things linked with it. We have verb point, which we have to keep in mind. We have to see if it is a simple sentence, like simple present, we use is MR. If it is simple past, we use was verb. And if it is simple future, we use BE word, right? Be, the first form of the verb be. And if it is continuous perfect tense or continuous tense, we have to keep in mind when it is a perfect tense, we have to use the word been. If it is a continuous tense, we have to use the word being. And if it is a sentence which is in the form of do, does, did, we change it to ismr. Did, we change it to was, were. Accordingly, the sentences have to be framed and conducted and done accordingly. Whenever this kind of scenario is there, the student should not miss it, that they do and perform well in the questions done by them. Besides this, you have to keep in mind one more special thing. What is that one more special thing? That is, if you are doing the questions, you must know how to mark out the error. Like, for example, in active passive, besides this, we have some passive voices where they have a fixed format of the preposition. Like, for example, the word like surprise. It has various synonyms. Shocked. How to use with active passive? I'm doing that, not the vocabulary. So if it is surprised, I'm so sorry. Surprised, shocked, bewildered, stunned, dazed, astonished. These are the words which mean in the form of surprise, right? With surprise, if we have, we never use the preposition by. As we have been doing in all active passive voice, they will not have by. So what will they have? The preposition at. This forms two things. This victory sign coming again and again. What? What is that victory sign? That you have a fixed preposition. With surprise, second thing, that surprise does not take the preposition by. So, the sentence says, her behavior surprised me. This is subject, this is verb, and this is object. Same way we change. Object, that is I, me changes to I was surprised by her behavior. In this situation, by is a problem and I will mark it at. Fixed case where you can blindly follow the rule of preposition that with surprise, we would not use at, right? You would keep this in mind and moving on to next things and next prepositions, which active and passive denies to use them with by. With the word married, again, the word by is prohibited. What do we use? A fixed preposition to. I married him, right? Subject, verb, object. Now, when we change and make up a table for subject and object, this is very much clear that this shouldn't be forgotten at any cost. I subject, so me is the object. We, it would be us. You would remain you in the subject-object scenario. he, him, she, her, they, them, right? And so the change here, he was married by me. No way. That's what is to be kept in mind. He was married to me. Would you remember this? Right. Moving on to the next, the third point here. Contain. We use the word preposition in. This box. This is a preposition case too, which is kept in mind. This box contains sweets. Subject, verb, object. Sweets are contained as per, we use the word by, this box. And what would be the change? Error. Yes, what is the error? We cannot use the word by. Sweets are contained in this box. Can you see that? And what more? The word fill. One more. I just lost check here. I hope you've written down the subject-object scenario. All the people and the words which follow the same will also follow it in this manner. The preposition you would use is with. People, fill. There's another synonym with it, thronged. You can mark it, the same would follow with fill, the word with. People fill or throng the streets. So you would change the sentence, the streets are filled, or the word thronged, what would be the word you would use? This would be the error, with people. Right, students? So I hope you understood the context thoroughly and you have done active and passive with a glimpse, a glance, and the basic concepts of it. So this is grammar decoded and this was active and passive presented to you. Right, students? Thank you. Please do one more thing before I end up. Please don't forget to inbox, write your comments, which topics you are looking forward to if you watch up this, because I would attend to all those needs and demands of our bright future lawyers, that what they would need and how would they prosper, do, you know, wonderful manner for the AILET preparation, right? Because if you excel in English, you would naturally clear the CLAT, not only clear the CLAT as per the students were having an hope. So don't lose hope. We've just told AILET is there. And in that case, you will surely mark out your things in the best of scenarios and do your best. Right? So write in the comment box what errors and problems and things which you did not understand and what are the things you're looking forward to. Right, students? Thank you.